Get ready, start. Coming to the internal affairs of the country, Madam Deputy Chairman, the policies of the Government of India for the last 15 years have been so manipulated that the rich people are becoming richer and the poorer sections of the people are becoming still poorer. The committee that has been appointed to investigate into the question of the distribution of income has not yet given its verdict. But it is common knowledge that the people who are in the higher ups have become more rich and the people in the lower rung have become poorer. The prices of essential commodities that the peasants and the workers use have gone up so high that they are not within the reach of the mass of the people of the country. Government have not taken adequate steps to bring down the prices and to stabilize the prices as was recommended by the Food Grains Committee. We are now in the third plan. While the plans are progressing, the number of the unemployed in the country is increasing. This is a very anomalous position. It is the government alone that can explain why, in spite of the plans, the unemployment problem is becoming more and more acute. As was rightly pointed out yesterday by some speakers, our agriculture has not been paid due attention that should have been paid to in a country where 80% of the people live on land. Some 3 or 4 years back, when Mr. Ajit Prasad Jain was the Food and Agriculture Minister, he was made to resign under shady circumstances as one who had proved not capable of solving the food problem in the country. A suggestion was thrown that the portfolio of agriculture should be handled by an important and senior member of the cabinet, and particularly in the states, by the chief ministers of the states. But nothing of the sort has happened. Whatever increase in food grains output we have obtained is not because of any increase in the yield per acre, but because of extensive cultivation. More land has been brought under cultivation and some irrigation facilities have now been provided. But the increase that we have seen is not in keeping with the demand that is necessary for us to feed 400 million in India. So whatever industrial development we want, the basic factor is that our agricultural economy should be improved. For that, all efforts should be made, more fertilizers should be used, and new methods of cultivation should be employed for growing more food crops and for growing other cash crops. In a review that was published by the Planning Commission itself, they have pointed out that there is acute shortage of power in more than 50% of the states in India. We have accepted a planned economy, we have completed 2 plans, and we are now in the third plan. I do not know why the Planning Commission or the planners concerned did not foresee this shortage of power in most of the states in India, and why they did not plan generation of more power so that people will not accuse the state governments or the planning commission that they did not work out the plans properly in order to have more industries and to have more food grains produced through lift irrigation in most of the states in Andhra, in West Bengal, in Bihar, in Karnataka, there is power shortage. Whatever power is available now is being rationed. There are thousands of units of small scale industries which are not working for want of power. And there are thousands of lift irrigation pumps which are denied power supply for purpose of irrigation their lands, and whatever power is supplied, it is supplied during nights, which is not very convenient to make use of the power and use the power for agricultural purposes. The finance minister, in the statement that he made in the Lok Sabha and which was placed before us, has stated that it was assessed that for the successful implementation of the plan, even after taking every possible measure for the development of our exports, which clearly must be given the highest priority, we would need external assistance of the order of ₹2,600 crores, and we have, however, been less successful in obtaining and utilizing the external assistance required for financing the imports necessary for our developing economy.